Thank you very much, and thank you, CMS, for organizing this 22nd International Conference on Chief Justice of the World. So I'm just going to share my screen. Is it visible, please?
Yes, sir.
Okay,
yes.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. So I'm just going to say a few words on this great occasion, Global Citizenship Education. I know this as considering the Sustainable Development Goal, we understood because a lot of this factor is going on, you know, so around 17 category we need to address. So I'm just going to share some few of the point from in this August gathering. As we know, there's education processes of facilitating learning, and definitely it is considering the knowledge, skill and values. As we already know that education is the key backbone for, as I mentioned, about the Sustainable Development Goal. And definitely a 17 Sustainable Development Goal, I'm just saying around number four. You know, the four, number four is quality education, one of the key component. As you know, this education promote the lifelong learning and opportunities for all. So whatever quality and compliances and other effective component, if we can integrate with our education sector, definitely in the long run, we can develop the right people for our society. And of course, in this SDG, these four teachers are the key factor to achieving this goal. So definitely we need to focus about this teaching style, teaching pedagogy, and technological development. As we know, there's a lot of this technological development is going on, because today, I'm sure there's Gandhiji will organize this even physically, but due to cause of pandemic, this is going to be the, you know, there's online. So that's why Sustainable Development Goal, I'm sure this quality of life need to be ensured, where human health and well-being, economy and environment, both of the factors need to also look after and integrate sustainable development in higher education, where I already mentioned the teachers and the teaching sustainable development and the research and other development factor. And definitely the industry, that is international network and industry academia linkage, should give them more strengthening opportunity for Sustainable Development Goal and definitely the quality education also. So to ensure the inclusive development, we need to look at the existing and emerging challenges. I'm giving some idea, you know, there's emerging challenges. As you know, the industry regulation 4 is already implemented. So that's why the industry and academia needs to be strengthened so that university graduates can be employed productively. I'm sure there's a lot of this subject need to be changed, outcome-based education need to introduce. And at the same time, academician and university need to go to the industry, talk with the right people and try to develop as much as possible. Because we believe that universities can be the living labs for sustainability. Because again, I think after this COVID-19, we understood, because a lot of this disruption is already going on. So pandemic is already, as still it is unprecedented. And, you know, we do not know when it will be really abolished from our society. So that's why we should say that this transformative and fundamentally technological development, we must need to be integrated in our system. Because a lot of the innovation, a lot of this technological development, as we are organizing this Zoom platform, you know, this Zoom, Google Meet, a lot of the other platform, Microsoft Teams, they are also develop a lot of this innovation. Because every day, I'm sure that you already experience that how much development, new feature is coming. I think today, whatever feature we are seeing, maybe tomorrow, we are not seeing the same feature. So the skills, what exactly the education system, the giving the skill, the life cycle analysis. So it is our time to understand this real scenario, because if we cannot implement our skills in the real world, and that's, then I'm sure that in some sustainability respect, it will not be effective. So all of our skill, what we'll be learning from the university, we need to implement it in our real life. As I already mentioned, high demand for online classes. I think whatever prominent university or mid-level university or grassroots level university, everyone is realized that hybrid learning, online learning, this all of these components now need to be also integrated one after another. And preference, you know, the presently, recently, you know, those lot of survey, it shows that the people, the students are now preferring the hybrid model, where the online and offline, both of them should be present. And of course, the increased transparency level also, we should justify that the students and teacher, both of them need to interact in such a way so that the effective education system need to be implemented. As I already mentioned, that quality education should be one of the key component for our sustainability. You know, a lot of these MOOC already they implement, like Coursera, edX, they already implemented a lot of technological integration they also enable. And you know, the metaverse is already in our door. So it is the time, and you know, this 5G, and due to cause of this quantum computer, I'm sure the technology will play a key role for our educational development and also the student teachers interaction. So changing educational environment, we must need to also the again the technology like artificial intelligence, blockchain, artificial, you know, there's a virtual reality, augmented reality, these sorts of big data, cloud, everything we need to be considered, because once upon a time people was very much eager to work in their workspaces, physical space, but now, you know, there's all of the giant like Facebook, Forbes, and Business Standard, everyone is already declared that they will prefer their staffs to work in the home. So this is the, I'm sure that, as you know, the Twitter is already declared that they are allowed their staff for forever. So you see, from our university, some of the initiative I'm showing, this is our campus. We always try to focus our campus as green as possible. And we know there's all more than 80% we are keeping as a green campus, as a green. And definitely we also do a lot of this biogas and a lot of this component where the students are, they are studying, they should learn practically from these sorts of component inside the campus. We also develop a genuine model for poverty alleviation. And definitely it is also the, for the developing for the financial challenging people. We also did a lot of this research and a lot of these activities jointly with a lot of the stakeholder. Like we already identified the ICT job market in Bangladesh, sustainable water consumption. And anyway, a lot of work we are already continuously we are doing. And due to this pandemic, we enable and implemented the smart edu system where more than 50 module is already effectively we are utilizing, and our teachers, students, everyone is already using this technology. We already declared our campus as a cashless campus, and we also developed virtual gate, you know, this is a 3D platform, because a lot of cases students are not able to come to the class. So we already giving them some feeling that whenever they will enter to the library or some auditorium, they will get the scope to interact with the right people and getting the information, download the data and everything. We also, you know, there's a virtual farewell ceremony we also organized between this time, this pandemic time, and before 1 year, 2 years back, we also, as I mentioned, because teaching is one of the key components, we also enable in our university a teaching apprenticeship fellowship. So before joining as a teacher, we already going through 3 months long training and prove their efficiency to become a teacher. So we also just open one innovation lab. So the student utilize the robot and other technology. And these sorts of technology like go to blending learning center, we also involve in our university. So I hope that with this technological development, as I already mentioned, we are trying to enable our university in respect of quality and, of course, as a sustainability. Thank you very much.
We're all familiar here in the group with the 17 SDGs, and included in the SDGs is a call for increased education in global citizenship, sustainable development, and climate change.
In this post-COVID world, there needs to be a redefinition of what is national security.
And Victor Hugo said, there is one thing is stronger than all the armies in the world, and that is an idea whose time has come. The balanced education of all the three realities of life that is material, human, and divine is the idea whose time has come.
I will specifically name three areas of study which have a very strong tendency to claim universal truth, universal appeal.
We feel an immense sense of accomplishment today that the school's focus over the last 62 years has been the building and shaping the character of its students so that they work for the welfare of all.